Hello, Minneapolis College graduates, and congratulations. I'm so happy to celebrate your academic achievement with you, earning your certificate, diploma, or degree from Minneapolis College. While we're unable to hand you your diploma in traditional fashion as you cross a stage, this virtual celebration of your success marks an important moment as you complete your program requirements during a time when you undoubtedly faced and overcame additional challenges due to COVID-19. As a first-generation college student myself, I remember how excited I was planning for my graduation. I hope you're finding memorable ways to celebrate with those who have supported you. You may be aware of the innovative celebrations our college has created, including our socially distanced Grad Fest, which happened recently on campus. I invite you to keep posting your graduation messages, photos, and videos to Instagram and Twitter using the hashtag MPLSGrad2022. This season of celebration reflects the core of the Minneapolis College mission. On behalf of our faculty, staff, and administration, I want to say how proud we are of your accomplishment and how grateful we are to have joined you on this journey. We recall all the challenges you faced and overcame. You worked hard, persevered, and are forever part of our campus community. Whether you transferred credits in from other institutions or began your higher education journey with Minneapolis College, most of you have been a part of our campus community for the past couple of years. During that time, our community experienced many changes and historic events, some on a local level and others spanning the globe. The events we experienced around social change have been perhaps the most challenging and memorable of all. Minneapolis College has reaffirmed our commitment to equity, dedicating our efforts to becoming an anti-racist institution. We've become a voice for desperately needed change in the community. We're bringing attention to inequities and are addressing them by embracing human diversity, communicating with respect, and striving to understand, disrupt, and dismantle systemic racism. By translating words into actions, Minneapolis College is helping produce tangible change. When you reflect on the time you've spent at Minneapolis College, you may not recall all these historic events. You were busy attending classes, navigating online services, studying for exams, getting to know each other and other students, making lifelong friendships, and having life-changing experiences. These experiences have shaped who you are today and how you will impact the community through your work and service. As you transition to studying elsewhere or taking your place in our region's workforce, you are now part of a historic moment that will change the world. As you continue to discover your role, you will help shape the post-pandemic world and the area's economic recovery. Now that you are an alumnus of Minneapolis College, I hope this isn't goodbye. Rather, I hope it's until next time. I'm eager to see you again as you find a place in the community where your talents and training are needed. And for those of you planning to continue advancing your education, you've achieved a level of success on our campus that will serve you well. I encourage you to get involved with the Minneapolis College Alumni Network and find opportunities to remain active in our community. When we encounter one another in the future, I invite you to say hello and share with me your reflections on how Minneapolis College was here to get you there. So, on behalf of all of us at Minneapolis College, we are proud of you for achieving this milestone. We wish you every success as you begin your next adventure. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the students, faculty, staff, family, and friends. Also to anyone who may just stumbled across this Zoom room. Today, I want to focus on three things that have helped us get to this point. Resiliency, vulnerability, and connection. When I started my academic career at the youthful age of 32, I didn't know which way was up or down. For those of you who do not know me, I'm Alex Vigil, and I am a person in long-term recovery. And I also am a proud member of the Addiction Counseling Club, used to be the former president, as well as a member of the Collegiate Recovery Program. The last 2 years, each and every single one of you has demonstrated some level of resiliency, vulnerability, and some level of connection. Those three things are some of the big factors and the reason why we're graduating today. First, let me talk about resiliency. The definition of resilience is the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. I don't know about all you, but I think back to 2020, and that was an exceedingly difficult year. During that year and the years to follow, we had to power through so much. I think back to May and the murder of George Floyd, all the injustice in our world that happened. It was traumatic for many of us. And for others, there were feelings of anger, sadness, and hopelessness. But despite COVID-19, civil unrest, isolation, substance use, and the decline of mental health, each of us has been able to show resiliency. We hung on. We nourished our brains, our bodies, and souls the best way we knew how. And one of those ways was through being vulnerable. Kriti Kambanda once said, "It is your vulnerability that makes you beautiful and stronger in your own way, because then you are more accepting to newer things." And if that's not the truth, I don't know what is. I think back to all the walls we had to let down, being on camera, sharing the things with people whom we've never met in person, reaching out for help and advocating for ourselves despite not being able to shake a hand or reach and give a hug. We had to share our struggles and our happy times in a way that we never knew was possible. Without taking chances, there can be no vulnerability. Brené Brown said, "Connection is why we are here. It is what gives us purpose and meaning to our lives." The power that connection holds in our lives was confirmed when the main concern about connection emerged as the fear of disconnection. The fear that something we have done or failed to do, something about who we are or where we come from, has made us unlovable and unworthy of connection. In April of 2021, the Addiction Counseling Club and the Collegiate Recovery Program were able to host the first big event since the campus shutdown. I was so excited to meet my fellow classmates in person, but with all the awkward, should I hug them? Should I shake their hand? Or maybe just give an elbow bump? It was weird and distracting. However, despite all the awkwardness, I still made connections, and I knew that the people I was meeting for the first time wanted to hug me just as bad as I wanted to hug them. Human connection is not perfect. It's not always going to be comfortable. And lastly, connection is not all about proximity. If you know me, and I'm going to guess that some of you do, you've probably had a hug from me at one point in time. Because why? That is the way I feel the most connected. The hugs during that event lasted what seemed like minutes, but the warm touch felt so inviting and humane. I hope that I can hug all of you at some point in the near future. I want to thank you for your time, for your resiliency, for your vulnerabilities, and your willingness to make a connection even with all the barriers that were handed to us. Now, this is the time where I should end with some cheesy remark, but I'm not going to. I want to leave you all with a gentle nudge to go out, give all the hugs you can, know that you are worthy of connection, and please practice some self-compassion and show yourself some grace. I am proud of you, and I am proud of myself. So take pride in how far you have come, and have faith in how far you are going to go. Thank you.
Hello, 2022 graduates. I join you to uphold a long-standing Minneapolis College tradition, providing a snapshot of the class of 2022. Among you, there are many earning an associate's degree with an overall grade point average of a 3.5 or higher. A large number are members of the Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society. Some are military veterans or serving active military duty. Many of you have served as valued members of a student life club or college initiative through which you made significant contributions to our campus community. These include members of these programs: African American Education Empowerment, also known as AME, American Indian Success, Collegiate Recovery, Lucha Latinx, our LGBTQI Pride, North Minneapolis Promise, Power of You, and Star Scholars. Many of you are parents, grandparents, international students, or were born in another country. Some of you have family members who have been attending Minneapolis College with you. And like many of our faculty and staff who serve you, the majority of this graduating class are the first and their family to earn a college degree. This snapshot of the class of 2022 demonstrates the breadth of lives being transformed through your academic achievements. We are so honored to celebrate you as you achieve your higher education goals and move on to the next exciting step in your lives.
Hello, amazing Minneapolis College graduates. I am honored to be among those recognizing your achievements today. I hope you savor this moment, knowing that you are now one of just 40% of adults in the United States who can say, "I am a college graduate." Please take a moment and say that to yourself right now. And as you do, know that as a college graduate, new doors will open for you, whether you choose to pursue additional education, begin a new career, or advance on your current professional pathway. Celebrating along with you today are our dedicated staff and faculty. Among them are three award-winning instructors, Lisa Bergen, Kleber Ortiz, and Jenny Sippel, recognized last month as outstanding educators by the Minnesota State Board of Trustees. Dr. Bergen and Mr. Ortiz received the further honor of being named by the board as Statewide Educators of the Year, the highest award for teaching in the Minnesota state system. All three of these individuals are shining examples of the high quality of education provided by Minneapolis College faculty as they engage students in learning experiences that help them gain new critical knowledge, skills, and abilities. The diploma you are receiving is evidence of the learning and development each of you has achieved through much hard work, persistence, dedication, and in many cases, true courage in the face of adversity. Thank you for entrusting us with this stage of your education. And now, as a representative of the faculty of Minneapolis College, I am pleased to hereby certify those students who have satisfied the requirements to earn an associate degree, diploma, or certificate, and request President Pierce confer upon them the award and all honors attached thereto. Congratulations.
I do now confer upon you your intended associate degree, diploma, or certificate with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Thank you.
So from all of us at Minneapolis College, congratulations on achieving this milestone. I wish you all the success you have dreamed of as you move on to your next goal. Congratulations.
We're still here graduating, so just don't let anything stop you.